Welcome to the Blog V Want, a vlog for bloggers. The today's topic is all about adding a donate on WordPress website free using the GiveWP plugin. So do you want to enable donation on the WordPress website? Are you planning to do that with the GiveWP plugin? If yes, then continue watching this video. Today I am going to show you a live practical of GiveWP plugin tutorial. So without any delay, let's get started. Before moving to the first step, let me tell you that we have also published the GiveWP tutorial in a text format on our website. You can read our guide if you want. And secondly, you should also watch this video tutorial about 7 WordPress plugins. In this video, you will get in-depth information about the GiveWP plugin. So the first step is installing the GiveWP plugin. Although we recommend its paid version, however, if you are new to donation management, then simply try its free version. As soon as you tap on the Activate button, the GiveWP Setup Wizard will be open up. Step 2, initiate the GiveWP Onboarding Wizard. Tap on the Start Setup button to initiate the GiveWP Onboarding Wizard. Step 3, define a donation cause. In the first step of this Onboarding Wizard, you have to define the donation cause and provide information about yourself. Later tap on the Accept and Continue button to move to the next step. Step 4, specify the location and currency from where you are fundraising. The currency you will have chosen here must be the same as the location of your bank account. Step 5, define your first fundraising form. In this step, you have to define what features you want to include in your fundraising form. There are a lot of options mentioned here which can be configured separately later. I need all these features for running successful donation campaigns. So I am going to select all features and tap on the Continue button. Step 6, preview the donation form and donation button. Based on the previous step responses, GiveWP has come up with a ready-made multi-step donation form. Don't worry, you can customize all options of this donation form later before publishing it on your site. For now, just preview it and tap on the Continue button. Step 7, configure add-ons. This is an optional step in which basically GiveWP asks you if you need their paid add-ons for extra features like recurring donations, donor cover fees, etc. We have created a separate post best WordPress donation plugin where you can learn more about GiveWP add-ons. For now, if you want to add any of these add-ons, then simply select it and tap on the Continue button. But for now, I am leaving add-ons. Now you will be back to WordPress. So far you have completed the basic configuration. Now it's time to move forward. Step 8, edit the donation form. In the step 6, GiveWP plugin had generated the donation form. In this step I am going to edit that form only. To edit it, simply tap on the Edit button. Step 9, customize donation form label and permalink. Well, this is the form editor interface you will be interacting with the most. A lot of options are visible here, but don't be scared, we will configure all of them step by step. For now, just rename the donation form label and its permalink. Step 10, customize donation form template options. Form template options are divided into 5 categories. Each of these categories has a bunch of options. Let's see what's inside under the visual appearance category. Here the first option is primary color. This is the global color of your donation form and would reflect in different elements such as buttons, line breaks, etc. Let me show you how it works. Currently the green color is set here. See, it will reflect into underlines, buttons and whatnot. Let's change it. It is recommended to set the primary color according to your brand. See, the color has been changed. Then we have font and decimal amounts. This is the global font option that changes the font of all elements. And the decimal amount option will round up the decimal amount input by the donors. I am leaving these two as it is. Then we have a bunch of options to configure in step 1. This is step 1 of our multi-step donation form. Just make sure to enable this switch, otherwise this step will be disabled. The remaining options can be filled according to your donation cause. One more thing, for this example I am going to accept donations only with PayPal, so it will be better to rename this generic donation button to donate via PayPal. You can always preview your changes by this Preview Changes button. See, our donation via PayPal button is ready. But still lots of things are left to compare. The second step in the template contains payment related options. We will talk about this donation amount input field and donation amount choices later. But for now, customize these options if you want. By default, GiveWB has set these values, but you can always customize them. Similarly, a few more options can be seen under the step 3 of this multi-step donation template. When a donor presses the continued button, he will land to this step where he has to fill in basic personal information. You may be wondering about this test mode notice. Currently, the donation test mode is active, but when you are ready to accept donations, you can disable it later. We will discuss this later. And right now only two payment methods are available to choose from. But we will add a PayPal donation method soon. So fill the information under the options of this step as we did here. Make sure to enable the donation summary option. It helps donor to quickly review their donation details. Next are the thank you page related options. Well, donors will have interacted with this page after they made a donation. All options are easy to configure. Just make sure to do not delete this parenthesis set up by GiveWP. These parentheses contain a special tag that will be replaced by its value on a donation form. For example, this name will be replaced by the donor name. And it is also important to enable social sharing options on the thank you page. So this is all about donation form template options. Let's move. Step 11, configure donation options. Well, in case you would like to show multiple predefined amounts in your donation forms like this, then check mark on the multi-level donation. Then it is highly recommended to enable the custom amount donation. It allows donors to donate according to their desire. Then set the maximum and minimum limits. Then set the label for the custom field from here. Currently, it has been set to a custom amount. Finally, you have to define donation levels from here. These levels will appear because you have chosen the multi-level option earlier. See, these are the donation levels currently set in the donation form. Step 12, configure form fields. Well, in this tab, options which apply to the form fields are available. All options are simple and don't require explanation. However, I just want you to enable anonymous donation and guest donation functionality. Step 13, configure donation goal. Well, currently it is disabled. But let me show you what will happen if we enable it. See, now the donation goal information will be visible on the first step. If you enable a donation goal, then it will encourage donors to donate the maximum amount they can. There are four donation goal formats that you can experiment with at any time. And after choosing the donation goal amount, make sure to define what would happen when a donation goal has been met. Step 14, configure terms and conditions options. Well, it is very easy to attach terms and conditions to the donation form. Just enable it, define the label, insert terms and condition details, and you are good to go. In the multi-step donation button template, you will see the terms and conditions field on the final step. Terms and conditions are the perfect way to ask for donors' consent before they initiate a donation. Step 15, configure offline donations. Navigate to this tab to enable offline donation modes like check or cash. Enable it and provide detailed instructions in the donation instructions field. When you do this, the offline payment mode option will appear on the donation button like this. Step 16, configure email notifications. First, Enter a name and the email from which all GiveWP notification emails are sent from. This is a very crucial step. Then expand the new donation tab and customize the new donation email notification template. The settings are straightforward. Likewise, you can customize all the email notification templates. Step 17. Preview the changes. It's time to preview the donation form and donation button because we have configured all form editor options. Just tap on the Preview Changes button located at the rightmost of the form editor and publish it if you are happy with the changes. Step 18. Add a donation button on WordPress using GiveWP. Well, we are all set to hook up the PayPal Donate button. For this, you have to copy the donation button shortcode and place it on WordPress. Either copy the shortcode from below the Preview button or from the All Forms page. Then open up the WordPress post in a Gutenberg editor mode where you would like to add the donation button. Tap on the plus option and search shortcode, select it, and enter the copied shortcode. Finally, preview the page to check whether the donation form is working or not. See, everything is working perfectly here. So this is all about adding a donate button with GiveWP. But wait. Although I have demonstrated the main steps so far. However, if you want to configure the additional settings, then navigate to our website article where further optional steps are mentioned. So thanks for watching this tutorial. If you want more information, visit our website article. The link is mentioned in the description. And don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon to receive regular tutorials updates.